So passage 5. So let me read out the passage. When at last mother and I sat down to supper, we were both tired. We had fried for ourselves potatoes and eggs, but neither of us was in the least hungry. Okay. What a day it has been, I said miserably. I could hardly believe that it was only that morning I had watched mother making my sister Anne's wedding cake. And now her engagement had been broken off and there would be no wedding. I know, said mother. But don't worry too much, my dear daughter. Such things do happen in life. Not worry, I cried. It was strange for mother to say that. I was certain she must be worried to death. I said, not too much, she explained. It's no use worrying. We can't do anything about it. What are we going to do with Anne? I asked. She'll carry on her job at the hospital. We must help her in forgetting it by keeping quiet. She'll take a long time to forget this unlucky day, I said. So this is the passage given to you. So it is in the form of dialogues, you can say. Let us see here. So there are three persons referred here. So the conversation, or you can say, the discussion was going on between mother and daughter. When at last mother and I sat down to supper, we were both tired. So let us concentrate on the hard words. When the word is ended with R or ER or RE, you should not loudly say it. Just you should say supper. We were both tired. We had fried. Just please underline fried. Fried. We had fried for ourselves potatoes and eggs, but neither of us was in the least hungry. Means they were so hungry. So please underline least. What a day it has been, I said miserably. Means I refers to, so let me concentrate here. I means the speaker, you can say. I could hardly believe that it was only that morning I had watched mother making my sister Anne's wedding cake. So she was preparing a wedding, just please underline wedding, and watched mother. And now her engagement had been broken off. Please underline engagement. Engagement had been broken off and there would be no wedding. Just already it is underlined, okay, no problem. I know, said mother, but don't worry too much, my dear daughter. Such things do happen in life. Such things do happen in life. Okay, right. Not worry, I cried. It was strange, just underline strange. Strange. For mother to say that, I was certain she must be worried to death. So worried, just please underline worried. I said, not too much, she explained. It's no use worrying. We can't do anything about it. What are we going to do with Anne? I asked. She will carry on her job at the hospital. We must help her in forgetting. Just please underline forgetting. Forgetting. Forgetting here only. Forgetting. It by keeping quiet. Please underline quiet. The spelling quiet. She will take a long time to forget this unlucky day, I said. Please underline unlucky, unfortunate or unlucky. So these are the some of the hard words that are seen in the passage. Now let us concentrate the meanings of the hard words also. Supper is given. Supper means night meal is called supper, that is called dinner. Every night meal is called supper, or you can say dinner. So we have breakfast. We have lunch, we have dinner, or supper is nothing but dinner. Dinner is nothing but supper, night meal. Supper means night meal. So we were both tired, right? We have fried. Fried means the way of preparing the curries, they fried. Dry, you can say, dry dish, you can say, fried. For our zealots, potatoes and eggs, but neither of us was in the least hungry. So, just neither of us was in the least hungry. We were not hungry because we were otherwise somewhat worried about the things. That is why we are in the least hungry. So, least means very less, you can say, hungry. What a day it has been, means some unfortunate thing might have happened there. Okay. I said, please underline miserably. So, miserably means, so, unkind. I said, pitiably. Miserably is nothing but pitiably means. I said, miserably means, helplessly I was speaking. That is called miserably or helplessly. Or you can say, pitiably. I could hardly before one that. And watched means I had watched mother making my sister. Watched means, so looking at the things there, you can observe, here observed, you can say. Here it is observed. Mother making my sister and wedding means, is no, wedding is nothing but marriage. Means what was prepared? Wedding cake was being prepared there. And engagement means, so engagement take place when a male and female are together to sit and for they are going to get marriage. So this is called an agreement between male and female human beings. This is called engagement. I know, said mother, but don't, correct. And one more word here, strange. Strange means totally new. Strange means totally new. I miss astonished. Here the context is, it was strange for my mother to say that. Okay, I'll explain afterwards. And worried. So, worried means just she was very unhappy. Worried means unhappy. I said not. Okay, right. And the last word is forgetting. Forget means just help her in forgetting means. Forgetting means just she should forget the things there. And quiet. Q-U-I-E-T. Quiet means calm. There are another word. Quiet and quiet. Q-U-I-E-T, this is called quiet, and Q-U-I-T, quiet, fit means just you leave it. Okay? This is the difference between quiet and quiet. So, this is how, and unlucky means unfortunate, bad day, you can say, bad. Unlucky is nothing but bad. Opposite word is good, you can say, lucky, unlucky, unfortunate, fortunate. This is how. So, these are the hard words that are given there. Now, let us concentrate on the grammatical points also sometimes. So, when at last the mother and I sat down to supper, we were both tired. He writes, and here the word supper I have given you. We had tried for our zealots, potatoes and eggs, but neither of us was in the least hungry. So, in this sentence, what is verb here? We had tried for our zealots. What is verb here? So, tried is the verb. So, every verb has got three forms. Present tense form, past tense form. That is fried. This is fried. Correct? Present tense form, past tense form and past the participle form. So, every word has got three forms there. Fry, fried, fried. Our zealots. To which part of speech our zealots belong? Our zealots belong pronoun, that becomes pronoun. Our zealots pronoun. So potatoes, that becomes noun. Eggs becomes all plural numbers are. If at all you remember the plural numbers, they are nothing but nouns only. Only nouns will have singular numbers and plural numbers. Potatoes, eggs. But neither of us was in the least hungry. So this least becomes adjective that qualifies hungry. Hungry is noun, least is adjective there, adjective, that least. What a day it has been, means the entire day was not at all a good day for them, because some unfortunate thing might have happened there. So that is only, she was saying that, I said miserably, who was, the speaker was saying miserably, pitiably, so helplessly, just she was saying there. I could hardly believe that it was only that morning I had watched mother making my sister Anya's wedding cake. Means, so on that particular day, they were preparing some wedding cake for Anya. Anya is sister of the speaker here. The sister of speaker here. My sister. So my means the speaker and sister Anya's means, so her sister here. So sister Anya's wedding cake, and now her engagement had been broken off. So in the morning hours they were preparing for the wedding cake, and after some time the engagement was broken off. That is why they were tired and they were some in miserable condition, had broken off. So broken off, this is phrasal verb. Broken off is phrasal verb. Verb followed by pronoun. Sorry, verb followed by preposition. Broken is verb and off is preposition. So this is not, that is nothing but phrasal verb. You should remember, even phrasal verb, sometimes broken off is given. So you should give the meaning of the broken off also. Means the engagement was broken off. Means we can say that was broken off. And there would be no wedding. So when engagement was broken off, there should not be any wedding there. That is why they were worried about the things. I know, said mother. So I know, said mother. I becomes here mother. I know, said mother. But don't worry too much. She was saying to her daughter, but don't worry too much, my dear daughter. Such things do happen in life. Life is a mixture of good and bad. We should receive good and bad things in a positive only. Then only we can enjoy the life. This is the, you can say, message of the passage. So you should not be worried about the bad things, and we should not feel excited with the good things. So we should receive the things in a positive way. So not worry, I cried. The speaker cried. It was strange for mother to say that. I was certain she must be worried to death. So means helplessly she was saying those words, but definitely she is worried about her NS marriage, or can say wedding. So helplessly she was in a totally miserable condition. She was almost near to the death in that way. Just she was using that word, worried to death. I said, not too much. She explained, it is no use worrying. It is of no use to worry. Now let us think over about the alternative things. We can't do anything about it now. So we can't do anything about it. What are we going to do with Anna? I asked, then what are you going to do with Anna now? Because her engagement was broken off. She will carry on her job at the hospital. Means Anna was working at the hospital. Now let her continue her work at the hospital only. This is, they have decided to go for the hospital. We must help her in forgetting it by keeping quiet. We should keep quiet so that she can forget about the incident that happened on that particular day. She will take a long time to forget this unlucky day. I said that is but natural to forget unlucky days, or can say bad days in life, but we should forget. This is, life is a mixture of bad and good things. So in this way, this is the passage. Now let us concentrate on the questions here. So the 21st question is like this. Where had Anna been working? So where had Anna, means just you see, the question is 25 in the paragraph, that is the first question, but here the answer is only at the end of the passage. So what are the getting to do with the hospital? Job at the hospital. So means you should confine yourself to the entire passage. Don't deviate from the passage for the answers. So answers may be at the beginning or in the middle or at the end of the passage. So your concentration must be only on the passage only, right? So in this way, where had Anna been working? So let us see the first of A option. She had been working as a teacher in a nursery school. So school is not referred. So in that way, this is deleted. B option is, she had been working at the hospital. So I think this is absolutely right. She had been working at the hospital. So this is right option there. Let us consider even on the C also. She had been working at a departmental store. Departmental store is not referred or not mentioned in the passage. So that C option is also wrong one. And D option is, she had been working at an orphanage. What do you mean by orphanage? Where the place where orphans are placed, or orphans are given shelter. This is called orphanage. Who are called orphans? The children who do not have mother and father. So let us concentrate on the orphanage. So orphanage, what do you mean by orphanage? So orphanage means the place where orphans live. The place where orphans live, or the place where orphans are sheltered. So this is called orphan. Then what do you mean by orphans? Orphans means the children who do not have mother and father, you can say. Means they are not with them. So this is, they are called orphans. So this is, the answer is here. The second option is the answer. There she had been working at the hospital. Right. Now let us go for the 22nd question. When did mother make Annie's wedding cake? So the first option is at night time. Second option is in the evening. Third option is in the morning. And D option is at noon. So let us see here, which is the right one there. So at night time, in the evening, in the morning, at noon. So let us go to the passage there. So I could hardly believe that it was only that morning I had watched mother making my sister Anya's wedding cake, and now her engagement had been broken off and could be in the wedding, right. So in the morning, so let us see, I could hardly believe that it was only that morning. That morning is given there, means in the morning only, just she was preparing wedding cake for Anya's wedding. So this, the option, which option is the right one there? In the evening. So B option is the right one. B option is the, in the, in the morning. So C option is the right one there, in the morning. Now let us concentrate on the grammatical parts here. So in the morning, in the evening, in the afternoon, or can say, you can use in this way, in the morning, in the evening, in the afternoon. In the afternoon means right from 12 to 6 p.m. that is called in the afternoon. But when sharp 12 o'clock in the daytime is mentioned, that is called at noon. That is called at noon. So you should differentiate at noon and in the afternoon. In the afternoon means the time that is covered from 12 p.m. to 6 p.m. 12 p.m. to 6 p.m. that is in the afternoon. And for night time, you can use at night time, or you can see use even during night. You can use in that way. So this is the way, ways of using the words there. So means in this way, just you can improve your vocabulary. You can concentrate on the grammar parts also, right? Now let us go for the next question, that is 23rd question. What was strange for mother to say? It was strange for mother to say, but don't worry too much, my daughter. So this is the dialogue delivered by mother. Let us see here. It was strange for mother to say she will carry on her job at the hospital. And it was strange for mother to say we must help her in forgetting in by keeping quiet. So it was strange for mother to say it is no use worrying, we could do anything about it. So I think D option is the right. It was strange for mother to say it is no use worrying, we can't do anything about it. So this is the A, D option is the right one there. D option is the right one. Okay. Now let us go for the next question, 24th one. Who will make a long time to forget that unlucky day? Whether mother or the narrator of the story. Who is the narrator of the story here? The speaker or I? I is the narrator, or okay, so the speaker is the narrator. So, right? And daughter is the narrator here. Daughter is the narrator, not NA. Another daughter is the narrator there. And C option is Anne's was to be husband. Anne's was to be husband. It's totally wrong. And NA is also given there. Who will take a long time to forget that unlucky day? So to whom that was unlucky day? Mother or narrator or NA? That is NA. D option is the right one there. D option is the right one there. And A, B, C are deleted. And the last one, 25th question is, how can they help NA? So how can they refers to here? Mother and another daughter, the speaker, the narrator. So let us see, A option is the, they can help. So here it is wrongly, print mistake is there. They can help NA by keeping quiet so that she may forget the event. B option is they can help NA by finding mother suitable match for her. So this B option is wrong. B option is wrong. C option, they can help NA by consoling her for what has happened. C option is also wrong. And third, D option is they can help NA by getting a suitable job for her. So the answer is A option. A option is the right one. They can help NA by keeping quiet so that she may forget the event. If at all you go on repeating the things there, she may be worried. So that is why you should make the things to be quiet. So this is the passage given to you. So fifth passage is completed.